So I've got the website open, and I opened up DevTools to the Network tab. I've hit refresh, and all of the network requests are shown. Here's one image, and here's the other. Notice that their size definitely isn't the same. One is 123 kilobytes, while the other is only 63 kilobytes. It looks like Udacity Large has different dimensions than Udacity Small. $0 refers to whatever element you have selected up in the Elements pane, which in this case is the image. When you do .natural width on the image, you see that its original width is 601 pixels. Now we want to take a look at the other image. Running the same command gives us 1202 pixels, so large is twice as big as small. The thing is, though, that both of these images look, well, pretty much identical. So there's a lot of wasted bytes when you deliver an image with dimensions that are just too large. Well, yes, some high DPI displays do need images that have larger dimensions than what's displayed. That's going to be a topic later on in this course. For now, just remember that images only need to be as large as they will be displayed. And what happens to your users on mobile? In DevTools, I've set network throttling to 3G, so I want to see what it's like for somebody on a bad connection. Let's refresh and watch. Ooh. Notice how the image on the right took a little bit longer to show up? That's just unnecessary. On a mobile device with limited connectivity, it's a big problem.